In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to calculate Dolby Vision dynamic metadata using the Dolby Vision analysis inside DaVinci Resolve Studio. Once your HDR grade is done and approved, double-check the Dolby Vision settings and make sure that Dolby Vision is enabled. The Dolby Vision version matches your delivery specifications. The analysis tuning is set to balanced. And the Dolby Vision mastering display selection matches the output of the color corrector as well as the calibration of your HDR reference display. If not done yet, set the correct output blanking for the entire timeline. Navigate to the timeline drop-down menu. Select output blanking and set the blanking for the timeline. For mixed aspect ratios, select a clip that differs from the global timeline blanking. Navigate to the sizing palette, and then select output sizing. Now, click the option menu and check show blanking clip override. Select clip and then uncheck use timeline blanking. This now allows you to manually input the desired values to achieve the custom blanking for that shot. Please note that all blanking values must be set symmetrically for either horizontal or vertical blanking. And all blanking must be set solely via Resolve's output blanking options. This will ensure that the letterboxing or blanking aspect ratio is properly stored as image aspect ratio metadata. Shot-based aspect ratios that are set this way will get recorded as L5 metadata in the exported Dolby Vision XML. After you have set the correct blanking or aspect ratio for the timeline or individual shots, the Dolby Vision analysis and mapping will only affect the active image area and will ignore the pixel information that the output blanking has blacked out. When viewing your content on any Dolby Vision consumer device, the display mapping will only map the image area defined by the image aspect ratio metadata. Now, before you run the Dolby Vision analysis in Resolve, you must first organize your timeline and arrange all clips on video track 1. Before you do this, it's a good idea to save the timeline as a copy so that your original timeline with multiple video tracks is preserved. Any group of clips that form a composite in a timeline, whether it's multiple overlapping clips combined via a key, alpha channel, or transparency, clips combined using composite or blend modes, or text and graphics that are layered over one or more video clips, must be converted to a compound clip for Dolby Vision analysis to work correctly. Please note that this timeline preparation is only mandatory when using DaVinci Resolve Studio. Other color correctors may not require this step. Before we run the analysis, let's briefly discuss the analysis tuning feature introduced in Resolve Studio version 18.6. This feature introduces a new and improved analysis algorithm that allows colorists to select the strength of highlight retention and the amount of mapping applied. Users can now choose from a predefined set of spatial filters. Selecting the legacy CM4L1 option matches the analysis of the original CM4 algorithm. Older projects from software versions created before this change will open with this selected as the default. The other options use the new analysis algorithm, each with a different strength for the spatial filter. The lowest strength filter retains the most highlight detail and applies the most mapping but should not cause any visible clipping. This option can result in producing the darkest starting point among the new analysis options. The highest strength filter often results in visibly clipped highlights, but applies the least amount of mapping, thus producing the brightest overall image when mapping to the SDR100 nits target. The balanced option is designed to permit clipping in some cases and reduce the strength of mapping, while preserving highlight detail. This is the default starting point and is recommended for all new projects. Analysis is a non-destructive process, and lost details can be restored using the trim controls that will be covered in the next video. Now, set the analysis tuning to balanced and navigate to the color page. Select the Dolby Vision tab and go over the analysis options. There are four options to choose from when running the Dolby Vision analysis: All, Selected, Blend, and Frame. All will analyze every clip or shot that is present on the timeline. Selected only analyzes the selected shots in the timeline. Blend will analyze multiple selected shots and then average the analysis result. Blend will basically analyze those selected shots as if they were one. This is a way to save analysis time and match shots quite effectively. frame, analyzes a single, user-defined frame in a selected clip and uses the analysis metadata from this single frame for the whole shot. This is a useful option for shots with varying lighting conditions. We're going to select all and let the analysis run on all the clips in the timeline. The Dolby Vision analysis performs a pixel level, frame-by-frame measurement of all the media on the timeline, subsequently producing and storing three values per shot that mathematically define the luminance range of each shot. The three values are minimum, which is the lowest black level in the shot, average, which represents the average luminance level across the shot, and maximum, which is the highest luminance level in the shot. These three values together are referred to as L1 or Level 1 metadata and form the basis of Dolby Vision content and display mapping. This metadata is used to tone map the HDR master image to SDR or any other lower luminance HDR target while maintaining the creative intent from the HDR version. After the analysis is complete, the min, max, and average values are visible in the designated fields in the lower left corner of the interface. If you hover the cursor over the min, max, or average labels in the UI, Resolve displays the analysis setting that was used for that shot. Changing the analysis tuning does not erase or invalidate existing L1 metadata, and L1 values will not be updated until the image is reanalyzed. There is also an HDR flag added to the clips that have been analyzed. All clips now have shot-by-shot metadata. However, once the Dolby Vision analysis detects a dissolve or any resolve video transition, those transitions are analyzed using frame-by-frame offset metadata. Once the analysis is done, Resolve now sends the HDR image, along with the calculated Dolby Vision metadata to the content mapping unit, the CMU, which in turn will map the PQ-based HDR grade to the specified target. The required target can be selected from a list of predefined target display outputs. We strongly recommend checking the mapping on the SDR100 NITREC 709 target display output, as this is the furthest from the original HDR grade. The SDR100 NIT target display output is selected by Resolve as the default. Once the Dolby Vision metadata is calculated, set your reference display to SDR. Make sure Enable Tone Mapping Preview is enabled, then set the scopes to SDR, and check the SDR mapped output. If you are using a separate SDR display and have configured your video monitoring with dual SDI outputs, the Enable Tone Mapping Preview button has no function because Resolve automatically outputs the tone mapping on a second SDI channel. You can additionally check the mapping at 600 nit HDR, as this target serves as a good reference for most Dolby Vision TVs. To do this, simply select the HDR target you wish to check, and set your HDR reference display and internal scopes accordingly. Make sure that the target display is set up to match the selected target display output. For all HDR home targets as well as the Dolby Cinema target, use a calibrated ST2084PQ HDR setting on the reference display or projector. Similarly, for SDR Home as well as various DCI Cinema targets, the display or projector must be set to the corresponding calibrated white point and gamma. Please note that you need to run the analysis again if you change the HDR grade or edit point. Therefore, we recommend that you first lock and approve the HDR grade before running the Dolby Vision analysis.